Mr. Heurta, thank you so much for taking the time for this interview. First, we'd like, can you introduce us to the work you're doing on a global scale?
Well, my name is Eric Huerta. Within the works I do, I'm a policy advisor on ICT telecommunications development for the Mexican government, and also I'm writing the toolkit, Connect School, Connect the Community toolkit, the part for rural and indigenous communities, and well, that's actually what I
okay.
do now.
So you mentioned that part of your focus is how ICT can lead to the social and economical development. So how is that possible?
Well, we sometimes tend to think that automatically when we bring ICTs to a community, they will accept it, use it, and start generating income, running business, ICT business. But the thing is that it doesn't happen that way. So it happens when the community get the chance to know the tool and to use it to what they do best. So this is not a problem only within the community. Sometimes even in some industries, even in some in some companies, or even in the government, when we start getting a new technology, people have to understand it and then to adapt it and apply it for what they do. And that is a process, and that is, well, sometimes people call it or name it as managing change. So, well, what we do is to manage change in rural areas so that they can use ICTs for their development goals. They already have their development goals. Some of them could be like producing more cattle, no? Some others could say taking better care of their environment. Some others who maybe will want to run a tourist project, a local tourism project. So, well, that's about how ICTs can help to achieve those goals that they have already set for them.
So when we discuss how ICT can develop rural areas, you mentioned some elements that could help in that process. So what are these elements?
Well, first, we have to have a policy on that. No? The market sometimes, because it's not it doesn't represent a good earning or a big business, so the big companies doesn't go to them. So sometimes we could have a very big company, some communication companies in a country, but we have a lot of uncommunicated areas in rural places. Because they are not good for, well, they are not profitable. No, well, they are not, they don't produce enough profit for the companies to be attracted to them. So the first is to do something in the law. Well, there could be any strategy. There could be, probably someone could say, okay, well, let's make a fund for taking ICTs to these areas. Some other will say, let's promote local companies to getting ICT on these areas. So this depends on which are the realities of the countries and how they develop a strategy. So first point is we have to have a strategy.
Okay.
Second point, technology. It's not the same, the technology for connecting a city to connect a rural area. Well, I'm just gonna give an example. Probably we have a very good equipment, but in rural areas or in the electricity barriers varies a lot. So it could be very high or very low. So probably a good equipment could that works well in a city that has a normal electricity supply might not work in that area. So we have to develop the kind of equipment, the appropriate equipment, or the good equipment for those areas. That's another point.
Okay.
Third point, and developing an industry. as I said, sometimes big industry won't work properly in small areas. Mm. They are so big that they cannot be sustainable in those groups. Mm. So we have to sometimes develop a small business here. Mm. For instance, India started, as the companies didn't go to these areas, they start developing a small kiosk, a small store, but they put a telephone in there. Mm-hmm. Then they put a computer and an ICT center. Mm-hmm. Then, so, probably for some companies was not good, was not a good business to go to those areas and put a telephone in each house because it costs a lot and it didn't represent enough income. But to have one telephone in a small convenience store could communicate an area. Mm. So that's kind of a starting small model. And the last point is to work with the community so that the community could take the tool, and use it for their development goals. No? Mm. So that is about the process on how we get technology to those communities.
So before the break, we were discussing how can we evaluate a sustainable ICT project. So can you let us know about how can we measure that?
Well, we have to see it first to the policy and regulation. Mm-hmm. We have a policy and regulation that promotes ICTs in rural areas. We have, first, if we have a policy, sometimes we didn't even have a policy. Mm-hmm. So if the country have a policy and regulation to promote this kind of telecommunications, that would be one point. The second thing is to see if this policy and regulation is working. Mm-hmm. It's reaching what we actually are expecting from it. Mm-hmm. The third thing is at community level. No?
Okay.
So what does community think about their projects? People is involved, people is doing the part of the job, or is only the government doing the job? Because sometimes when the government goes on the left or start giving support, the projects fail. And in this case, what we need is that the community start running the project by themselves. Mm-hmm. So in long term, are the people able to run the project? The project will be sustaining in long terms, even without the help of the government? That's the last point to evaluate.
So an interesting concept you mentioned is the needs of strangers. What did you mean by that concept? And if you know some examples that would illustrate for the users?
Well, yeah, needs of a stranger approach is a very common phrase in community development. We have to know that most of the development projects fail. Mm. There are studies about 20% of the projects, development projects supported by the UN sometimes, failed. Mm-hmm. Sorry, only 20% work, 80% fail.
Okay.
And the problem is mostly about the needs of a stranger approach. What is the needs of a stranger approach? Sometimes we think that people that live in the city can know the needs of the rural areas. Mm. So we come with our needs and project them in the rural areas. I was saying about this example when I saw this guy teaching the people how to do financial transactions from one account to another and teaching them these marvels of telecommunication on how to do financial transactions. Mm. Well, that was good for him,